Where is your home? Ari, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean.
Hello to everybody. I hope all of our students and families are doing well and everybody's staying healthy during this time at home. Today we are going to have a read aloud story. Hope you enjoy the story. So as we're reading this story, I want you to think about the characters and how they're acting, and I also want you to think about the events that are taking place. So after, you could go back and retell this story to somebody at home. All right, we are going to get started. Far beneath the ocean waves in the land of the mer people lived a lovely young mermaid named Ariel. Her home was in an undersea palace. Although it was quite magnificent, she hardly ever spent time there. She preferred to go exploring or out looking around with her little friend Flounder the fish. Ariel loved to collect objects from the world above the sea. She and Flounder would swim in and out of sunken ships, picking up whatever caught the little mermaid's fancy. So this shows Ariel, and she is sitting on a rock in the water, and she is petting her friend Flounder the fish. And this shows the beautiful large castle or palace that Ariel lived in under the water, and it's very tall and has several different layers on it in the ocean. Ariel's father, King Triton, ruled the undersea kingdom, so he was in charge. He was very proud of Ariel's many gifts, especially her beautiful singing voice. He had arranged to give her a special concert to show his daughter's wonderful talent to all of the merfolk. Ariel's sisters sang to begin the concert. Then they sang a special song to introduce Ariel. But Ariel wasn't there. Where could she be, I wonder? Triton was not pleased. How could Ariel have forgotten to show up for her own debut or her appearance as a singer? So this shows all of the mermaids, and they are performing their song to introduce Ariel. And King Triton is sitting on his throne or his chair watching the introduction. And Sebastian is in the picture, and he is conducting the song. And they're all waiting, and Ariel is nowhere to be found. As usual, Ariel was off exploring. Sounds like exploring must be one of her favorite things to do. She had found a sunken ship to play in and had forgotten all about the concert. By the time she returned home, the guests had left. Triton was so angry that he ordered Sebastian, a crab, in his court to follow Ariel and to keep her out of trouble. I wonder if that is going to help, having Sebastian follow Ariel around. Later that day, Ariel slipped away again, with Sebastian following close behind. She hadn't gone far when a huge shadow darkened in the waters above. "It's a ship," she gasped with delight. Sounds like Ariel is very excited to see this ship. King Triton is very angry with Ariel. He's pointing his finger at her, and Ariel has a scared look on her face. And then in the next side, Ariel is swimming away with Sebastian following close behind and her friend Flounder the fish. And she is pointing up to the surface where there is an outline of a ship in the water. Ariel swam to the surface to get a closer look. There were humans on board. One of them was very handsome. Ariel heard the others call him Prince Eric. But as Ariel watched, a sudden storm took them all by surprise. To her horror, the ship began to sink or go down beneath the water. Most of the people on board were able to climb safely into the lifeboat, but the handsome Prince Eric was hit by a falling spar or board and thrown into the churning water. So Eric is on his ship and he has his dog by his side. And Ariel and Flounder and Sebastian are watching the ship in the distance. The ship in this picture is starting to sink and crash below the surface. And you see several of the men in a smaller boat or a lifeboat, and they're paddling away. And Prince Eric is holding on to a piece of the ship and he's floating in the water. I wonder what Ariel is going to decide to do. What do you think? Ariel knew that humans could not live under the sea. She had to save the prince. There was no time to lose. She darted or swam very quickly through the waves towards the prince as her friend Scuttle watched nervously. So you can see here, there's Eric. He's floating in the water, and Ariel is swimming through the water to try to get to Prince Eric. Using all of her strength, Ariel dragged the young prince to shore. Scuttle was waiting for them. The silly bird put his ear close to Eric's boot. "Sorry, Ariel, I can't make out a heartbeat," said Scuttle. Ariel placed her head on the prince's chest. "Oh, he is breathing, Scuttle," she cried. She was so happy that she began to sing to the prince. The sound of Ariel's lovely voice, Eric's eyelids began to flutter. So Ariel is sitting on the sand and Eric is laying down and she's holding on to his head. And in this picture, she's putting her hand on his chest to try to feel his heartbeat. "He's going to be all right," Ariel said. Gratefully, "Now I'd better get back before Father finds out I've left." I wonder how King Triton would react. I wonder what he would do if he found out that Ariel left and is on the surface right now. When the prince opened his eyes, all he saw was his faithful dog, Max, running towards him. Ariel returned home, but she couldn't forget the human prince. As she sat thinking about him, two evil eels named Flotsam and Jetsam watched her with their cunning eyes. So Ariel's back under the water and she's sitting on a rock and these two eels are swimming up towards her. And they have very long tails and they are looking at her with their sneaky eyes. "Come with us," they coaxed sweetly. "We know someone who can help you." Ariel followed the slippery eels. Before she knew it, she was inside the deep, dark cave of Ursula, the sea witch. Ursula knew how much Ariel missed Eric. She told the young mermaid that she could help her visit him for a price. I wonder what that means. What price, or what do you think she will make Ariel do in order to let her go to visit Eric? This picture shows Ursula the Sea Witch, and she has black tentacles. And she is standing in front of a mirror, grinning at Ariel. And Ariel is swimming away with the two eels surrounding her. "I will make you human so you can visit your young man," Ursula said. "But you must get him to fall in love and kiss you before the sun sets on the third day. If you fail, you will turn back into a mermaid and return to the sea and do whatever I say." Then Ursula laughed wickedly. "Oh, and one other thing, you must leave your voice with me." What will Ariel do without her voice? Poor Ariel. She would have done anything to see the young prince again. So she signed the agreement. Then the evil witch locked Ariel's beautiful voice inside a magic seashell that she wore around her neck. You see, there's Ariel here, and she is standing next to the sea witch, Ursula. And Ursula's holding a scroll, which is a long piece of paper that says agreement between Ursula and Ariel. And Ariel is putting her signature on that, and Ursula has a big smile, laughing face. And the eels are in the background, and they're also smiling and laughing about what is happening. So Ariel is willing to give up her voice in order to become a human and go to the surface. Flounder and Sebastian watched in amazement as Ursula's magic powers changed Ariel into a human girl. Suddenly, Ariel could no longer live underwater. Luckily, her two friends rushed her up to the surface so she could breathe. Ursula cackled with glee. She meant to make sure Ariel would not get her kiss. Because remember, what was going to happen if Ariel got her kiss? She was going to get to stay on the surface, and Ursula did not want that. Once Ariel was safe on the beach, Scuttle said, "There's something different about you, Ariel. I just can't put my foot on it." She showed him her two legs. She wanted to tell Scuttle about what happened to her. But since Ursula had taken her voice, Sebastian had to explain. So Ariel has made it up to the surface, and she's sitting in some water, and she has her foot out of the water, and she looks like she's wiggling her toes, and she's showing to Scuttle, and Flounder is in the water near her, and Sebastian has an angry look on his face. And what do you think Sebastian might be angry right now about what's going on? Remember what Sebastian was supposed to be doing, his job? When Ariel tried to stand, she found that balancing on her new legs was harder than it looked. Sebastian shook his head in disbelief. "How am I going to tell the king about this?" he wondered. Meanwhile, Eric had not forgotten about the girl who had saved his life. Although he hadn't seen her, he had fallen in love with her wonderful voice. Then, as he was walking with Max, he saw Ariel on the beach. "Have we met before?" Eric asked, his heart skipping a beat, letting us know he was very excited. But his hopes were soon dashed when he found that Ariel could not speak. She must not be the one, he thought. So Ariel is hiding here behind this rock, and Eric has a big smile on his face, and he has Max, his dog, with him. And Flounder and Sebastian are also there with Ariel. And Ariel almost has a little bit of maybe a confused or worried look on her face right now. Still, the prince felt sorry for Ariel, so he brought her to his castle. The next day, the prince took Ariel for a ride through the kingdom. "She's so lovely," Eric said to himself. "If only she were the girl I've been searching for." So Ariel is at the castle, and she's standing in front of a mirror, and she has a beautiful blue dress on. And she and Prince Eric are riding in a horse and carriage. They're taking a ride through the kingdom. The next day, the prince took Ariel for a boat ride. Although Ariel didn't know it, the prince was falling in love and was just about to kiss her. But the eels had been watching. They tipped the boat over and sent the couple tumbling into the water before Ariel could get her kiss. So this is Eric and Ariel, and they're in a boat ride in the water, and they're getting closer together. Ariel has her eyes closed, and Flounder and Sebastian and some of the ducks are around the boat, And then the next picture shows the eels coming up, swimming together, and the boat is tipping over, and it looks like Ariel is about to tumble out into the water. Ursula had been watching the couple in her magic bubble. She decided to trick Eric so Ariel would never get her kiss. The witch transformed herself into a beautiful girl. With Ariel's voice locked inside the seashell necklace, Ursula would sound just like Eric's true love. The following day, Ursula walked the beach. The sound of Ariel's beautiful voice filled the air. Eric could hardly believe his ears. The girl who had saved his life had finally come back to him. Quickly, the sea witch put a spell, taking away Eric's choice, and he decided to marry her right away. And Eric is standing on the beach, and Ursula, the sea witch, is putting a spell on him, and she's walking, and Eric looks a little bit confused by what's going on. Ursula's nasty trick had worked. She and Eric were to be married on his ship that very day. In her cabin or her room, Ursula laughed as she looked at her true reflection in the mirror. So she's looking in the mirror, and even though she looks differently now, she doesn't look like Ursula, the mirror is showing her true reflection of Ursula. Luckily, Scuttle saw Ursula's real reflection too. What do you think Scuttle is going to do? What would you do if you were there and you saw what was happening? Scuttle and Flounder rushed off to find Ariel and tell her about the sea witch's latest trick. "Don't worry, Ariel, we will help you," said Scuttle, as Flounder pulled her out to the ship. Then Scuttle flew to the ship. So this is Ariel, and she's holding on to a rope in a barrel, and Flounder the fish is pulling her through the water towards the ship, and Scuttle is flying up above. And I wonder what they're going to do when they make it to the ship. Let's find out. With the help of the sea lions, pelicans, and other birds, Scuttle stopped the wedding. As Ariel climbed over the railing, the birds tore at Ursula's clothing and pulled her hair. The seashell fell from Ursula's neck. When it broke, Ariel's voice returned to her instantly. The pelicans and the sea lions are tugging at Ursula's dress, and the seashell necklace is on the ground and it's broken in two pieces. And Eric and Ariel are watching all of this happen. Then Eric knew he had been tricked, but time had run out. The sun had started to set, and Ariel was already turning back into a mermaid. But Eric was not about to let Ariel slip away this time. Grabbing a harpoon, or a very sharp spear, he dove into the sea and threw it at the sea witch. So Eric has this long wooden spear with a sharp end on it, and he threw it at the sea witch. And this picture shows the harpoon hitting her in the arm, and she is holding her arm, and she has a look on her face like she's in pain from that sharp object hitting her arm, and Ariel is swimming away. That made Ursula angrier than ever. She transformed herself into a huge monster and tried to crush poor Ariel and the prince. Eric clutched the little mermaid to him, trying to protect her, save her from the witch's anger. Okay, so this picture shows Ariel and Eric in the water, and they're next to the ship, and Ursula is standing over them. She's very, very large at this point, and she is threatening to crush them. And Eric is holding on to Ariel very tightly. His arms are wrapped around her, and they're both looking like they have scared or panicked looks on their faces as they look to Ursula. Eric knew he had to do something fast. What do you think Eric is gonna do? Well, Eric aimed the ship's prow at Ursula and sailed as fast as he could. As the boat struck the witch, she let out a terrible scream. Then she was gone forever. So Eric climbed up the side using a rope, the side of the ship. He got on the ship and he began to steer it, and he drove that ship right into Ursula. Everyone was glad the sea witch was gone, but Ariel was still unhappy. I wonder what Ariel was unhappy about. I wonder what Ariel wanted. Even Triton could see that his daughter was truly in love. So using his magic powers, he granted Ariel her dearest wish. He made her human again. Triton watched as Eric and Ariel walked towards the castle. "I'm going to miss her," King Triton said to Sebastian, "but I know they will be happy." Soon after that, Eric and Ariel were married in a shipboard wedding. And just as King Triton had predicted, they lived happily ever after. So King Triton is standing and he has Sebastian on his shoulder. And he is in the water and he is waving to Ariel and Eric. And they are holding hands and they are on the sand and they are both smiling. And they are getting ready to go live happily ever after. And Flounder is in the water and he is smiling too. So that was the Little Mermaid story. After reading that story, I want you to think of the events that took place in the story and to see if you can retell the story of the Little Mermaid to somebody at home, to tell them the events of what happened first, what happened in the middle, and what happened at the end of the story. And also, if you can pick out one of the characters, Ariel or Ursula or King Triton, to tell somebody at home about. So thank you for joining us for The Little Mermaid, and we look forward to reading more stories with you. Thank you, and goodbye. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While the devoting full-time floating under the sea. As up to the wind they roll. The fish on the land is happy. The shark does day in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky. They in for a worse of fate. One day when the boss get caught. Yes, you go beyond the plane. What no? Under the sea. Under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee.